Before April 1954, the common belief, the universal belief, because it had been tried again and again and again, and people had failed, the belief was that man was not physically capable of breaking the four-minute barrier, that he could not run a mile in less than 4 minutes. That was the belief on the planet. It had never been done. But here's what happened, ladies and gentlemen. Roger Bannister came along, and he broke the four-minute barrier. Now, here's what's significant about that. Since that time, up to this day, over 20,000 people have done it, including high school kids. What changed? 20,000 people, what changed? Here's what happened when they got on the track. They knew it had been done. And because they knew it had been done, there was a new belief about this barrier, about this goal that was unreachable. And those 20,000 people got in a race believing, knowing in their heart that someone had done it, that it's possible that they could do it. And I'm saying that if you know anybody that had some goal, some dream, something they wanted to do, and they did it, then I'm saying that you know in your heart that if someone has done it, then you can do it. It's possible.
I don't know if anyone knows what it is you find when you reach down inside for something and you have to make it happen.
It's always about human values and the incredible resolve of two teams who pushed themselves to the limit with a world championship at stake.
We have goals that we want this team to accomplish, but maybe more than that, it's just fighting for each other. Challenges are ahead, and we're excited about being a part of it.
This ain't our house! They hate us! It's us versus 100,000!
We don't lose the Lambo! We don't lose the Lambo!
In our business, there is no second place. Either you're first or you're last.
Skip on the beat.
Hey, I hear you gonna eat the stars, man. I'ma need what's on your plate. Give me that.
You shall not pass!
Versace, Versace, Medusa head on me like I'm Numinati. This is a gated community, please get the fuck off the property. Rap must be changing cause I'm at the top and there's no one on top of me. Niggas be wanting a verse, but man, that's not a swap to me. Grinding in compliments, pool in the backyard that look like Metropolis. I think I'm selling a million for sweet, man, I guess I'm an optimist. Born in Toronto, but sometimes I feel like Atlanta adopted us. What the fuck is you talking about? Saw this shit coming like I had binoculars, boy. Versace, Versace, we stay at the mansion when we in Miami. The pillows, Versace, the sheets of Versace, I just want a Grammy. I've been so quiet, I got the world like, what the fuck is he planning? Just make sure that you got a backup plan, cause that shit might come in handy. Started a label, the album is coming September, just wait on it.